भगवद्गीता 9th चैप्टर 2nd वर्स। राजविद्या राजगुह्यम पवित्रम इदम उत्तमम प्रत्यक्षावगमम धर्म्यम सुसुखम कर्तुम अव्ययम। दिस चैप्टर इज कॉल्ड राजविद्या राजगुह्य योग। सो द योगा ऑफ द किंग ऑफ साइंसेस और द किंगली साइंस राज विद्या। सो हियर श्री कृष्ण सेस इदम दिस राज विद्या द किंग ऑफ साइंसेस दैट मीन्स द हाइएस्ट साइंस राजगुह्यम। राजगुह्यम मीन्स अ किंगली सीक्रेट दैट मीन्स अ ट्रूथ विच इज वेरी प्रोफाउंड quite profound, which is quite deep, subtle. So it is Raja Guhyam. It is Guhyam, it is profound, it is deep, but not in the ordinary way, extraordinarily deep, extraordinarily subtle, extraordinarily secret. The word secret in English does not bring the complete meaning of this word. Guhyam does not mean secret in the manner somebody wants something to be hidden. Guhyam means something which is deep, so deep that to understand that one has to put much effort. That is what Guhyam means. So it is not palpable, it is not directly perceivable, it is imperceptible, it is not visible to the senses, it is not what we say in Sanskrit indriya gochara. Chara means that which is perceptible, go means indriya. So, indriya gochara, there is a repetition of indriya. So, gochara means that which can be seen by the senses, which can be perceived by the senses. So, when Shri Krishna says Raja Guhyam, what Shri Krishna here means is that this is a secret which is profound. It is a secret in the sense that it is very deep truth. To understand this truth, one should go into greater depths of experience. Uttamam, and also it's a supreme truth. It is that truth beyond which there is no other truth. There's nothing else to be known after one has known this. Pavitram, it is pure, or it is something which can make other things pure. It's a purifier. What do we mean by purifier? Purifier means this does not give any scope of any impurity. That is the meaning. So, purification, whenever there is impurity, we say it has to be purified. So, there is water and water is there, it might be impure, and then we need water purifier which will purify water and make it potable or make it drinkable, fit for drinking. So purifier, water purifier. So there, when we talk about purification, there is the understanding that there is something which is impure to begin with, and so you purify it. But here when we say purifier, what it means is there will be no scope of becoming impure. How? Suppose you know that your uncle or some such relative is having a large amount of wealth, so much wealth that not only you don't need to earn any money in your rest of your lifetime, but also maybe successive generations don't need to earn money. Now, before you get this knowledge, you might have been running from pillar to post for gathering wealth. But the moment you get this knowledge, then you don't need any more wealth. Then you suddenly know that you are wealthy. You then know that you are wealthy. Once you know that you are wealthy, then you don't need any more wealth. And so the position that you are poor can no more be possible. Just this information that your relative, I mean, I'm not talking about a relative who will not give you money, a relative who will not only give money, but also the money possessed by that relative automatically belongs to you. That kind of relative. Once you know, the very moment you know that this relative has got money and I am in a position, I would be in a position to use it, the thought which you were carrying that I don't have money vanishes. Similarly, when you know that you are not this body and the mind, the moment you know that you are much beyond body, mind and other, all these five sheets of your nature, Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Anandamaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, etc. When you know that you are beyond all these sheets, then it is impossible. When you know with an unshakable conviction, when you have this firm, deep-rooted conviction, then it is impossible to attain the state of being impure. Why? Because a person becomes impure only at the levels of these five sheets. One cannot become impure at the level of Atman, because it is Sat, Chit and Ananda. It exists, absolute existence, absolute knowledge and absolute bliss. That means when we use the adjective absolute, what we mean is there cannot be something more existing, more blissful or more knowledgeable or conscious than Atman. So the moment you know that I am the Atman, after that instant you don't need to be purified, because you know that it is impossible for you to become impure in the first place. So that is why it is Pavitram. So this truth is purifier, in the sense it gives you the knowledge that you are not impure at all to begin with. So Mother, Holy Mother Sarada Devi, she says to a person that when she wants to, she has this obsession. She was not diagnosed, but I think she had what is it called? OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. So this Nalini ji, she says she wants to go and take bath now and then, every now and then. So which in Bengali is called Shuchi Bai. And so one person is obsessed with cleanliness. So Holy Mother says, you just touch me. Don't now go and take bath and all, just touch me. What does it mean? Holy Mother is by this action giving this idea that you are pure to begin with. You don't need any external rituals of purity, purification. So Pavitram. So the knowledge, this Raja Vidya, this king of sciences. What is the king of sciences? That which stops, puts an end to all inquiry is the king of sciences. Simple. That by knowing which you know everything is king of sciences. So this question was asked by Einstein, but much before that, people, rishis of the Vedas asked this question, Kasminno Bhagavan Vijnate Sarvamidam Gyatum Bhavati Iti. So what is that knowing which I will know everything? So Albert Einstein also asked this, give me one force, what is that one force which will explain all the four forces of nature? The weak force, the strong force, the electromagnetic force and gravitational force. Now physicists have understood that the gravitational force is nothing but a different form of the electromagnetic force. So now they say, give us one force which will explain the three basic forces of nature. Strong force is the force which binds the nuclear particles, the particles of the nucleus of an atom. And the weak force is the force with which the outermost electron is bound to the nucleus of an atom. And the electromagnetic force, what is that force? Even now scientists are doing that research. That is what is that knowledge, knowing which you don't need to know anything else. It puts an end to the very process of knowing. That is why it's called the kingly knowledge. So in legislation, for example, if in India there is some kind of a jurisprudence, there is some kind of a suit, and you are going one after the other, you are going to different courts, the ultimate authority in law in India is the Supreme Court of India. So the moment you go to Supreme Court of India and the Supreme Court says something, the only other body which can set something other than what Supreme Court has told is the parliament, the legislator, legislative body can make. But Supreme Court also, they have to give weightage to what Supreme Court has said. So in law, in judicial system in India, Supreme Court is the highest body. So that means once you go to the Supreme Court, then you can't do anything about it. Similarly, once you know this vidya, then all your need for knowing comes to an end, because you have known all there is to be known. So that is why it is Raja Vidya, Raja Guhyam, Uttamam, Supreme, Pavitram. As I just now explained, it is something which tells you that there is no need for purification and is the ultimate purifier. Then Pratyaksha Avagamam. And another thing, see, though it is Raja Guhyam, though it is something which is deepest of the deep truth, though it is subtlest of the subtle truth, but at the same time there is a paradoxical kind of oxymoronical idea here. It is something which is covered, but it can be realized directly. So how is it possible to realize or see something directly which is covered? If something is covered, the very idea is that you cannot see it directly. And if you can see it directly, that means it is not covered. Logic. When does this happen? When does something which is just in front of planes, in plain sight, as they say, is not seen? In magic. No, in magic. It happens in illusion. In plain sight, see, we are told PC Sarkar, one whole train, he kept it invisible. It happened in reality. So in plain sight it is there, you cannot see, because you have been hypnotized, or it is illusion. So this whole world is nothing but illusion. That is why we are unable to see that there is nothing but Brahman. It is in plain sight, but you cannot see it. So that is how you understand that these two contradictory thoughts are both true for this. Pratyaksha Avagamam. Pratyaksha means direct perception. Avagamam, it is known. By direct perception, Sri Ramakrishna was approached by Swami Vivekananda, then Narendranath Datta, and Swami Vivekananda says, have you seen God? And Sri Ramakrishna says, yes, yes, I have, not only I have seen God, I have seen him more clearly than I see you. Not only that, I can also make you see God. So not only that, it is a reality, but it is a reality in plain sight. So that is why across religions, across religious traditions, across faith traditions, whenever someone comes face to face with this ultimate reality, what they say is, it's very simple to see it. Now we are breaking our heads and say, ah, we are not able to find God. And they come and they say, it is very simple. Ramana Maharshi says, just keep quiet, you will know. In Tamil, he said, Summa iru, just be yourself and you will know. That is the whole issue here. We can't be ourselves. We have to be something extraordinary. So that is why what is there in plain sight, we are missing. It is just in front of, it has been always in front of us all the time, but we are missing. Why? Because we don't understand who we are. That is the problem. Unless you understand that you are the relative of that multi-billionaire, It's not going to help you. Billionaire in not in rupees but dollars. Okay. So, or let it be pounds also. When we are supposing, let us suppose something very great. Multi-billionaire, and suppose somebody has say 1,000 billion pounds. I don't know if there such person exists. What is there in imagining? What harm? So, unless I know that I am a relative of that person, I am not going to get anything. Though I am a relative, I might not know. So, the fact that I am a relative is not going to be produced. What is going to be produced is, I am now knowing that I am the relative. Or, to put it in another way, my ignorance of my being a relative is going to be destroyed. So, all along I am Brahman, or I am not this body mind. My true nature is Brahman. Will it become that when I get that knowledge? No, it has been so all along. Only I come to know at that time. So, that is why pratyaksha avagamam, and you cannot know it other than by direct perception. Why? Because it is something which is aparoksha anubhuti, not paraksha anubhuti. It cannot be known by external sense organs. It can be only known by something which do not take the external sense organs as the medium. So, it is immediate perception, not mediate perception. And so, that is why pratyaksha avagamam, it can be known only by direct perception. And dharmyam, what is dharmyam? Dharmyam means endowed with dharma, that which has got dharma. What is dharma? That which is our basis, that which follows the basis. What is our basis? Our true nature is Brahman, that is our basis. So, that which follows this true nature of us being Brahman is dharma. Now, dharma is also understood to be synonymous with virtue, morality, ethics. Why is it understood to be in or to be synonymous with virtue? Because everything has got a nature. So, that is also another meaning of the word dharma. Dharma means nature. So, we say any liquid is dravya. Dravya means it has got a flow. Dravati iti dravya. So, something which flows. So, every liquid, what is the property of a liquid? It will flow. Some will flow more, that means it will have less viscosity. Some will have more viscosity and flow less. But every liquid will flow. Very good. So, the dharma of liquid is flowing. Fluidity is the dharma of liquid. Any liquid will be fluid. It will have the capacity to flow. So, it is its nature. So, we say, that fellow, you see, always this fellow has a constipated face. Always, in Bengali, we have a very nice expression for that. Khek kore uthe. Means that person, you go to that person, always something that person will say, never will have a cheerful face. Oh, shavavtai rakam jano. Means his nature itself is like that. That person's nature itself is like that, constipated fellow. We cannot expect any cheerful face from that person. So, that is the swabhava. Okay. We cannot do anything about that. Swabhava, dharma. So, liquid is dravya, dharma. Cotton is very light. If you keep cotton and if there is even a bit of wind, it will fly. So, that is the dharma of cotton, light as cotton, is light. So, suppose you take some delicious dish, if it is cooked properly, it will be delicious. That is the dharma of that dish. Nobody says, oh, ice cream, I don't like ice cream. Everybody likes ice cream, okay, unless you get diabetes, poor people. But otherwise, everybody likes the ice cream. So, then you say, I love ice cream, how nice ice cream. People, there are some sweets or food which unfortunately some people use to bust stress. So, that is the dharma. Now, if you don't like ice cream, then if ice cream is okay and you don't like ice cream, that means the problem is not with the ice cream, it is problem is with you. If you similarly you see some liquid, they say it is a liquid, but it is not flowing, means what? You have a container in which a liquid is there and you are trying to pour it, but nothing is coming out, means the container is closed or there is something obstructing the container. Simple. If there is liquid inside the container and if you pour it, it should come out, because it is the dharma. Similarly, if your nature is sat chit ananda, if your nature is that you are always existing, always conscious and always blissful, and you have a constipated face, means there is some problem. You are not following your dharma, or there is something which you are not understanding, means there is some problem. Or you think that you are going to die because of corona, again there is a problem. Of course, corona is a very unfortunate disease, but what Bhagavad Gita, in Bhagavad Gita Shri Krishna says, one who jatasya hi dhruvam mrityuhu, one who has been born, that person's death is certain. And the opposite also true, unless you get your knowledge of your true nature, moksha, then a person who is dead will again be born. So if you think that you are just this body and mind, that means you are not following your nature. If you don't follow your nature, you will do something which is against your nature. Against your nature. So what will happen? You will think that you are the body and the mind. And if you think you are body and the mind, you will try to attain bliss through the body and the mind. And you may go and take some drug like LSD, something, ecstasy it is called. But that ecstasy is different from this ecstasy. Why? Because you want to get bliss through the body. Many people, once they take these psychedelic drugs, they say, oh, it was very blissful. There is a liquid which many people, it is a South American liquid, it is found, a herb is made, and it's called ayahuasca, I think. Yes, they make a liquid and then they drink it and vomit. Buckets full of vomit, and they will get all kinds of vision, and so that is a bliss they get. That is through the body you try to get a bliss, and that is wrong. Why? Because it is against your nature. What is your nature? Are you body? No, I am not body, that is my nature. That is why apramattaha, that means one who does not err, one who does not do any mistake, commit any mistake, unerring. This word is used for people who have realized their nature of being Brahman or Atman. Why? Because they know that they am not the body and the mind, so they cannot commit something which requires the knowledge or the illusion that I am the body and the mind. So that is why dharmyam, once you know that I am Atman, then you will not do something which is unethical, immoral, because you know that I am not the body and the mind. And also, most of the times we do these things to get bliss, but when you know that you always are in bliss, when you experience that bliss, you will not need to hunt for some ways of attaining bliss. Okay, so that is why kartum susukham. Now again, you see here, there are many contradictory ideas, apparently contradictory ideas, which Shri Krishna gives. He says, it is very easy to perform. Kartum susukham. In the 6th chapter, Shri Krishna is asked by Arjuna. Then he says, you see, chanchalam hi mana Krishna, pramati balavadridam, tasya aham nigraham manye, vayorivasu dushkaram. That this mind is so restless and pramati, and it makes me commit mistakes. Why? That means it makes me go against my nature, true nature. And balavad dridam, and it is very forceful and very firm. Tasya aham tasya nigraham manye. I think that to control that is vayoho iva dusu dushkaram. It is very difficult, just like controlling the wind. This is what Arjuna said. एंड श्री कृष्ण रिप्लाइड असंशयम तु महाबाहो मनो दुर्निग्रहम चलम अभ्यासेन तु कौन्तेय वैराग्येन च गृह्यते. देयर इज नो डाउट, इट इज अनडाउटेडली माइंड इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कंट्रोल एंड इट इज क्वाइट रेस्टलेस, बट बाई द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ अभ्यास, बाई प्रैक्टिस, कॉन्स्टेंट प्रैक्टिस, रिपीटेड प्रैक्टिस एंड दिस पैशन वैराग्येन गृह्यते, इट कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड. ओके, सो देयर ही एक्सेप्ट्स दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कंट्रोल इन द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर एंड हियर ही से सुसुखम इज वेरी ईजी. इट इज वेरी ईजी टू वेरी ईजी टू नो दैट यू आर आत्मन. सुसुखम कर्तुम सुसुखम, it to do it very simple to do. So if you go to, suppose Abdul Kalam was alive today, you go, sir, how a rocket is, are very simple, don't you see the photo? I am having a vest and I am sitting with some other person. That photo is very popular, recently they used it in one movie also, in a different way. So one person is sitting and something they are doing, you will, if you see that, you will feel like some gardening is going on. Actually rocket science is going on, not joking, really rocket science is going on. So that person is sitting, Abdul Kalam, in one what we call banyan, and that means vest, and with another person. So if you go to Abdul Kalam, you say rocket science, so many rockets I have said, nothing, it is very simple. But for the uninitiated, definitely it doesn't appear so simple. So Shri Krishna is saying kartum susukham, it's very simple, very simple. Everyone says that, very simple. Holy Mother Shri Sarada Devi said, I did all the works, all the vegetable I used to cut, I used to cook and all that. Every day I used to perform some 1 lakh japa I perform. How could you do that? Very simple. So people did arithmetic calculation, geometric calculation, calculus, differentiation, everything they have done, and they have broken their heads. How can somebody do 1 lakh japa in one day? So very simple. Kartum susukham. So why, how is it simple? See, because there is nothing to do, that is why it is simple. You have to understand the secret here. How is it, everybody is saying it's very simple, very simple. At the same time, they're saying it is difficult to control the mind, etc. You don't have to do anything. Just be as you are. Now we hear this and our mind is not pure. And we say, just as am I, I'm always eating and sleeping. If I just, I am as I am, then I will get realization. You will not get anything realization. You may get some lifestyle disease, that's all. So if you have to understand what you are, then you have to get rid of the obstacle called the mind, the obstacle called desires. Then you will understand that I am always this. Once you understand that you are always this, you don't need to do. Shankaracharya, in his beautiful creation called the Adhyasa Bhashya, which is his commentary to the Brahma Sutras, there he says, two things are obstacles to this knowledge. What are they? Kartrutvam, bhoktrutva. The idea of agency, doership. I am the doer. And the idea of enjoyership, bhoktrutva. These are the two problems. So the moment I realize that I am not the doer, I am not the enjoyer, then I become free. Then it is very simple because nothing has to be done. Kartum susukham. It is very simple. All you have to do is be just in that knowledge that you are that. Tattvamasi. So, avyayam. Also, beautiful thing is, you see, again, Sri Ramakrishna was told by Totapuri, if there is a brass vessel, you have to constantly polish it. Okay. And immediately Sri Ramakrishna says, but what about if it is a golden vessel? If it is a golden vessel, you don't need to polish. So this knowledge, if it is a knowledge which you have got yourself established in, if it is a knowledge, then it becomes wisdom. That knowledge, then it becomes wisdom. You know, I am Brahman. I am means not this body, mind, etc. My true nature is Brahman. So then whatever happens to your body, whatever happens to your mind, you are totally free. You are totally free because you know it doesn't matter. Matter does not matter. Matter does not matter. So once you know that matter is inconsequential, it does not matter, nissara, it does not matter, it does not have any essence, then you become happy. And this is something which will not change. Like you don't need to polish the golden vessel, this will not change, avyayam, it is not going to change. Once this is a fundamental knowledge and unchangeable wisdom. It is not that after some time suddenly rishis will come, see, now we have changed our syllabus, now Brahmagyana means not this, we have, this is old syllabus. You have got Brahmagyana in old syllabus, now this syllabus we have updated, so now again you study and again you get Brahmagyana. That is not going to happen. Once you know Brahman, once you know your true nature, that is going to stay all the long. It is not going to change. So, you are not going to become outdated. You don't need to shift to a better software or better hardware. It's not necessary. So, kartum susukam avyayam. Not only that it is easy to do, but it is not going to change. All you need is once you attain this, then you are fine. You are good to go kind of. Once you attain, then you are good to go from this samsara. You are good to go. Means you have to just leave and you go, that's all. Moksha you will get. Once you attain, then you don't have any. So once, only once. So Swamiji says, you see, just once I will experience this Nirvikalpa Samadhi, then okay. Trick. Once if you experience Nirvikalpa Samadhi is enough. Then no, you don't need to experience Nirvikalpa Samadhi every time. It is like telling, little one drop of Amrita I will take, that's enough. I don't want more. One drop also if you take, that is enough. So, kartum susukam avyayam. It is something which is very easy to do, and once you attain it, then it is going to stay with you all along. So, this shloka, this verse is like a trailer. When you want to see a movie nowadays, even in web series, you will have this trailer. So they will cull out many scenes and in 1 minute or something they will put, then they will put one big text, they will put some words, they will put, then you are intrigued. Afterwards you watch the series and you say that it was hopeless anyway. Trailer was well made. Okay, trailer was done very well. But here it is not like, the trailer is also good and the movie also will be good. So Shri Krishna, you see, he wants to create an intrigue. He wants to intrigue you. So in the first two verses, he creates this curiosity. What is this? Easy to do and it will always remain and you will become suddenly ethical and you will have all this. It is the kingly secret, kingly wisdom. What is this? And it will make you pure and you can directly see it. All the qualities he has told. So now we will see how to attain that knowledge, and after we read this chapter, then I am sure that all of us would get the knowledge of Brahman. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.